mean, pretty much it's all about power. And it's about power in each relationship that we're in, each dynamic that we're in, even out on the street, we go to a corner store or whatever. So it's all about power, interacting. We're interacting with people, that's energy, that's power. So we just have to be aware of it, is what people are asking us. Anti-oppression 101 that comes from the 80s, 90s, just asked us to be aware of power in each relationship. And that means that we have to be aware of the fact that there are going to be people who experience more oppression in the world, more social stigma, racial profiling, that kind of thing, gender, that kind of thing, your status in life, that kind of thing. And more globally, what has happened is that basically more and more people are desperately poor and more middle class are falling to poverty, and they know it. So a lot of them are trying to fight for their position and support the status quo, the government, the police help do that as well. Others are trying to quietly change it from within. That's radical feminism right there. It's supposed to be liberal feminism. That's what it was supposed to be. You get in and just work away at changing it and chipping away and boom, boom. But what happens is when you get there, like the radical feminists warned and said, look, this is probably what's going to happen. When we get there, like politicians, you're just basically trying to survive with the position you have. It's not so much that you sell it right away, but it's almost near impossible to change it from within because they keep you running around and divided so much, you're freaking almost losing your mind. So any privilege you have nowadays, man, you are working for that privilege. Like, ooh-wee! Working for it, man. And they ain't giving you enough at all. And it just divides community from you, mostly. And us, we don't get to hang with you either. And for those middle class that we do hang with who are very, very involved in social justice, you know, it's just amazing that they get, it's just a miracle, because really, it's really difficult to do that. So I have a lot of respect for people, you know, who are doing that work. But I lost my train of thought, but I think I laid down. It's about power dynamics, so that we're just aware in each situation. And it's about building relationships, like Stephanie Lovett reminded me recently, and she's an amazing woman. Is a major, amazing community builder. And worked at Clubhouse Model in Calgary for years, and is highly respected amongst people who are struggling in poverty and mental health. But it's about building relationships. We have to build relationships with each other, and we have to keep in mind each of us has a story, and then politicize it by being aware of other people's stories and their experience with, say, for example, the police. Some people have good experiences with the police, and they personalize it, and they said yes to that. And that, I get it, I understand. No hard feelings, it's all good, I really do get it. My mom, you know, I was raised in a good way, so. However, we need to consider radical feminism in the 80s and 90s. Women of color basically asked us to look, consider which lens we are looking through. And we're being asked right now to look through really critical analysis, political lenses. And really, really, we really must come together and unite against the systemic oppression that is now encouraging the rise of fascism. So we just gave police power for a year. We're gonna have to, we have a year now to kill the ACT team. Pretty much, take it off the budget because it's not needed. I saw the ACT team with SWAT go in and deal with somebody who's schizophrenic at Central Care Home. And just like the video says on Thaw YouTube there, the people near, all his friends could have helped better. By the time they got there, which is 4 days later, you know, they found out he was suicidal because he went and talked to staff at Portland Hotel. 4 days later, the SWAT team shows up with ACT. You just gave two more to that team. We got to get rid of that team and put the money back to the mental health team. And I remember who they are. They're still around. They're still working. And they are good at what they do. And they need their money back so that they can be doing outreach at night. And yeah, that's it.